Hi, welcome back to our channel. We are Chase and Melia, and today we are reacting to Siti Nurhaliza once again. This is her most recent performance, I guess. It's a big show live in 2021. That's super crazy. Exciting to see what she's doing lately.
Absolutely. I think the most recent performance we had seen before this was like the Smule recording. Oh, so it was not even like,
sure, it was
like, you know, live big, it was just her production.
On an iPhone,
exactly.
Camera, you know.
So it's super exciting to hear her this year, like last month, what she sounds like right now.
This video was sponsored by a friend of the channel. His name is Shu Hai, and he's been great to us. So thank you, Shu Hai, for sponsoring this video, for introducing us to Siti Nurhaliza, and for recommending this one.
Absolutely. If you guys are new to our channel and this is your first time watching us, we love to talk about singing and we love to watch these reaction videos and use them as an opportunity to teach you guys something. We also want to learn something. We're going to break down what she's doing. We're going to talk about what we assume is happening technically and why it's great, why we would recommend maybe not to do it, all of the things.
Sure.
We just want to dive in and listen to some really good singing. So let's get started.
Hey, dengani kata orang, kalau rasa sayang, jangan kau mudah nak naik berang. Dalam cinta, kena berjaga.
All right, what do you got so far?
Wow, so I feel like this is the first time we've heard like kind of like a poppy.
Yeah, this is super poppy.
Yeah, super poppy. I also think this is the lowest I've heard her sing kind of consistently.
Yeah.
Like she's hanging out in a lower part of her register. I'm just not used to hearing that from her.
Yeah.
I feel like she still has a lot of the same resonance that we talk about a lot of times when we listen to Siti. But I would say preference-wise, I'm missing something.
Well, I think this is the beginning of the song.
I agree. No,
I agree. It's definitely not what people, you know, fill the seats to
totally,
see is,
totally.
Is her low notes, right?
Right.
We all have sweet spots in our voices.
Definitely.
But one thing that I really wanted to point out, because this is something that I struggle with, when I sing in my lower range, I lose a lot of clarity. Mm. And it's something that I think she did really, really well.
I agree.
I know where we are, and so I'm going to back it up.
No, absolutely.
Something that I think she's doing really well, as soon as she starts, she's still very forward. A lot of people, when they sing low, they push down in their chest and they, and that, it feels, you feel very powerful,
right?
But a lot of that feeling is the energy of your voice being lost in your chest.
It's actually
so
lost,
if you're feeling a lot of it, that means they're not hearing it,
right?
So if you watch her, we're gonna say vowels per usual, but kalora sayang, it's still very forward, very up there. Kalora sayang, like you can do that in your chest. And it's going to lose a lot of that stuff. But she's keeping it
still
really high, really up here.
Yeah.
And she's not pushing it down her chest.
Right, right.
So I just think that that's, if you want to know how to sing low, that's how you do it.
And I would say, too, it really helps with intonation. Like, obviously, the resonance part is a great thing, but also you want to stay in tune. And it's really easy to kind of lose your pitch if you're heavy and you're sitting on it.
100%.
But if you keep that resonance and that airflow, by having, you know, more forward placement, that would be really helpful.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
It's actually harder to sing in tune with low notes than it is with higher notes. It all has to do with the frequencies. It like doubles every time. And so when you get lower, they're, you know, the difference between 10 hertz is a lot.
It's a lot bigger than when you're singing higher.
Yeah.
The room for error,
of
error.
It's pretty wild.
Awesome. Let's go back to where we were.
Berkira dengan pasangan salah faham dipendam, luahkan kata, jujurlah caranya. Tanya sama hati, apalah yang dicari? Nanti jawab hati, hanya cinta bagi.
So I also, just listening to this example, she's always been a great model of speak singing, what we call speak singing, where it really just sounds like it would be the way she's speaking. I mean, yeah. It sounds very natural and fluid, and she kind of does a little back and forth in that second verse where she almost does kind of speak, like, yeah. It almost like she is speaking, but you can tell, you can barely tell a difference because her technique is so natural. She's not like creating something, you know, and manipulating her voice to be something that it's not. Yeah. She's just kind of allowing it to sit where it is. Again, this is a different spot than we're typically used to hearing from her, at least from our perspective.
Absolutely.
So I think that that is just a really good example of how she does this technique of having a natural voice wherever her voice is, right? Wherever she is in her register. You know, we hear her where it seems like she shines, mm-hmm. and it seems like she sings with ease. And we all have places like that in our voice.
Yeah.
But it sounds like she's applying those same techniques even in her lower register, which might be more difficult. But I think it's just a really good example of that.
I think it takes more work, right?
It does.
I think that if you want to use the full range of your voice, you mm-hmm. have to be prepared to keep certain aspects and really work on certain things to keep the clarity, to keep the things that you want to keep.
Keeping clarity. Yeah, you absolutely. Know,
it's really awesome. Also, she's dancing.
Yeah.
And we're actually going to be, it's just like, you know, it's... Well, she's got, but she's
no,
got
she
some
does
quick
have some stuff.
Leg
yes,
movements
that's
and she's
going to
know
true.
Exactly when that happens. And
that's
she's
true.
Thinking about how she's singing low, keeping that good technique.
No, that's true.
It's a lot.
And
it's
she smiles the entire time, oh every gosh. Time.
Yeah. Have you heard anything like that before?
No, I haven't.
Yeah.
Not really. It's interesting. I feel like the timbre of her voice has changed comparatively to like recordings we've heard, but I guarantee it's because of her age, because a lot of the recordings we're listening to
are pretty old.
So she's probably, it's probably 10, 20 years ago.
Yeah.
I don't remember, but you can tell that her voice, the timbre of it has changed, mm-hmm. and it seems like an age thing, because what I expect to happen is I expect it to be heavy, and I expect her to not make it, and I expect her to like not have the power and resonance and all of these things that we are so used to her having. But she still does.
Yeah, 100%.
She still does, but it just sounds totally different.
Yeah.
I would say it sounds more mature. Like, it seems like an age thing.
Totally.
Yeah.
Totally. I definitely, it's been a while, right? Since we've listened to some CT.
Right.
But it definitely sounds kind of bigger and a little huskier.
I would say so too.
You know?
That's what I mean.
But
like, I expect
clarity,
it to be heavy.
Like, it's just, yeah, it's
yeah, but
just,
it's not.
Yeah, it's
but it is different. And we have been told that, like, she had kids. She, you know, wants to lose weight.
Happens, right?
All of these
life
things
happens.
Have happened. And we were watching her perform. She was probably in her 20s, right?
Oh, I don't even know.
She was probably in her, like, early 20s. Who knows?
People, there were a lot of comments of people saying, this video is so old.
So old, yeah.
You know, go see how she sings now.
Right.
And, you know, we just recently reacted to videos of ourselves singing,
mm-hmm.
and it's, you know, it's a long time. Well, no, that was pretty recent.
Mm-hmm.
But we found some older videos of us singing, and mm-hmm. I sing completely different than I did even 10 years ago.
And that was only 10 years ago. So I think the other thing to talk about, even with, like, her age, and we're completely speculating here, we talk about, like, Mariah Carey as an example, who has kind of abused her voice over the years, had a wonderful career, you know,
a lot of people
did some amazing
things,
but you watch her kind of more recently and it's definitely different, and if you hear isolated vocals you can hear the struggle. I'm not hearing that from Siti. I am hearing a difference, and I am assuming it's because of age, but I wouldn't say she's lost her health or technique or clarity. I would say that she just has a more mature voice, and this is how your voice develops. It's just like anything. If you're an athlete, you're gonna run differently 20 years you know, later from the height of your career or whatever.
Well, and I think that speaks to how she's been singing.
Absolutely.
How she's been singing is she's been singing in a way that, you know, that she can still sing now 20 years later, you know, and that's how I want to sing, you know. That's
and
how
I think this is a good point to bring up too. When we are talking about like longevity of singing, we don't mean like, oh, you can do exactly the same thing all the time. You're going to lose some stuff. Some of these things, and not even just because of age and stuff, but because of practice. Like maybe she just isn't touring anymore.
Yeah.
Maybe she isn't recording anymore. Like there are so many factors that go into being a singer, being a performer, being a vocalist that, when we talk about having a healthy technique, it's so you can have the option of doing it all. It's so that you can still sing with good technique, not so you can do the exact same thing that you did in your 20s when you were practicing all the time, singing high notes. You know what I mean? Or whatever.
Yeah, we were actually having a conversation about how I kind of almost learned more by stopping singing. You know,
absolutely.
We were practicing so hard, but I learned more about my voice just kind of letting it happen. I feel like she's singing a more Western modern music, however you want to say it, style.
Yeah.
And that's going to sound different.
It's going to sound different.
But she's pretty good at it. That little run there was very, I would say, you know, Western music kind of typical. And
absolutely.
And she killed it.
Yeah, awesome. Absolutely. It was great.
Great. So.
Super cool. Say, like, the language that she's singing in is not super friendly to singing in this example. There's a lot of closed consonants, and I guess like and like even like and like sin and hing, you know what I mean? There's a lot of like consonants that are vocalized, so it's like a hum, right? So it's a consonant, which means your mouth is closed, but it's vocalized.
So voice and non-voice is actually like, for example, the F sound and the V sound. It's the same mouth shape, but one is a voice. I add my voice to it. And one is not. I just add air to it. And V.
Exactly. Now, those are English Western consonants as we understand them for the voice. There's going to be completely different consonants here. But I'm hearing a lot of those like, but even like things that are voiced, like adding voice. And you can tell, too, that obviously this is a native language. Like, she is very skilled at singing in this language because she has so much energy going through it. It doesn't lose its clarity. It doesn't lose its resonance. When she hums and sings, it has brilliance to it, which is really, really difficult.
I wish I could hum like that.
Right.
Having a really good hum where people go, you know,
exactly.
You know, and it still has the ping, the clarity that we always talk about is so difficult. I would say also that this section of music is very exposed.
Oh my gosh.
You are by yourself on stage. The music is low.
Yep.
Most of the music that's happening is coming from you, from your voice.
Absolutely.
And if you've ever been in that situation, it's a lot. You have to be very, you know, confident in your mind and not think about, oh my gosh, I'm out here by myself.
Right.
Oh my gosh, you know, nobody's here to back me. Oh my gosh, you know, all that kind of stuff.
And I would say too, there are brief moments of her intonation being a little wobbly, I think. But I would say overall, this might not seem like a very impressive
section
of song. But for those reasons alone, even just it being low, it being vulnerable, and it's impressive to us. And it's something that I think you guys should notice when you listen to singers, because this is, you know, I think that's what's beautiful about knowing, because then you can be like, wow, what she does is impressive, even if she's not singing across the sky. You know what I mean? Singing up into the rafters or whatever, like in the range. I feel like a lot of times that's like the only thing that impresses people.
Yeah.
So this is impressive and it's really exciting to listen to.
I have to talk about the jump real quick. It was so good. So, let's hear it again. What I want to point out is Same vowel.
Yeah.
She's not going, ah, you know, a lot of people, when they want to hit that high note.
Or like change.
They change the vowel. They go, you know, they have to, you know, but it's proof, you know, don't need to do all this other stuff.
Right. I also think it was a really good example of like her vowel was there and her air was flowing before she even began singing.
Yeah.
And you can tell that because it immediately had vibrato and resonance and like it was completely in tune from the beginning. There was no like finding it, you know, or like kind of getting there.
Yeah, she's set and ready
in
to
a
go.
Moment. You know what I mean? And so as we'll listen to that one more time, and then as we continue, she sings our favorite vowel, and we'll point it out. That's the one. Do you hear how that changes? Na 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 ah, because it's an ah, but then once she switches to specifically, I think that part in her voice, it's so bright, and just resonant. It's like the most resonant sound that can exist.
And she sounds huge,
she's
you know, but
huge,
she's standing there just doing her thing. It's not hard.
It's not.
Her. And it doesn't have to be hard for you either.
You can do it too.
You know, we see a lot of singers. We work with a lot of different musicians.
Mm-hmm.
And all of them are working very, very hard.
Yeah.
And that could be a stylistic choice, whatever you want to call it. But to me, it's not working smarter. It's just working harder.
Yeah, that is.
And if you want to, you know, have a very long career where you're still singing just as good as you were 20 years ago.
Decades after you begin,
The how matters. And you working harder is going to,
you know,
make that harder as well.
I'm so pleased at what we're listening to right now.
Good.
Yeah.
sorry to pause again.
No.
That's air.
So that, much
you know,
air.
Our kind of law or creed, yeah, or whatever you want to call it, the way Malia and I think about singing is air and vowel.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that she's just adding air,
yes,
to these vowels that she has that, right, we keep pointing out.
Right.
And it's beautiful. Then it turns these breaths into phrases. You know, right, I'm just going to back it up a little bit.
Right.
Because all she is just adding air. Air. Adding, yeah, air. Yeah. Adding air. And she can do whatever she wants, mm-hmm, to.
To the end. Through
beautiful.
The end.
All the way through. Start to finish.
Uh-huh.
Very consistent. Kind of was started flat and then she came into tune.
Into it?
In like a very, I think that was
kind of like
very
a slide.
Stylistic slide.
Okay, okay.
In like a really.
It was also a key change, right?
Oh, was it?
I think it was.
Oh, gosh.
Or a song change. Key change. It was a key change.
Oh, my gosh.
She's so impressive.
That was awesome.
She does really difficult things.
Oh,
and
man.
She makes them all look easy.
And the. Slides are hard because, yeah, if you go too slow, people think you're singing out of tune. And if, mm-hmm, you go too fast, people don't really notice.
It's like so a perfect art.
It, yeah, was like a, it was a, it really good time,
right,
that she spent getting
into
tune.
It. Absolutely.
It was perfect. It, yeah, was like, if it makes sense, just out of tune enough. You know what I mean? You want a little
want
bit of
slide,
that because
the
you like the dissonance.
Right.
You like the tension that
right,
creates. But then you slide into tune and that creates
and
that relief.
Yeah.
You know, that resolve.
Totally.
Exactly. Man, that
I know.
Was good.
진짜고 북한 니 아타스 그타스 진짜고 그타란 양 삼아 다 블루디 박사 다 블루디 차리.
She's so good.
So good. She's so good.
She's so good.
She's so good.
I'm sorry. I mean, we've said a lot that I think was better than She Is So Good.
Better than She's
but
So
you
Good.
But you get to this point with her where you're just like,
what else do you say? I'll see you soon.
Oh my gosh.
Every time I watch her, though, I think of something that I can do better.
Oh, absolutely. I've
you
learned
know,
a lot.
Her starting this phrase particularly, mm-hmm, was dynamically, mm, really nice. Mm-hmm. You know, she came out this big thing, and she's not quiet,
no,
and intimate, but she is kind of just talking.
Just,
it's not,
yeah,
a deep thing. It's, and then she, you know, breaks into this.
But it's
this,
also so resonant.
Yeah.
Like,
every
the clarity
bit
is there regardless of her dynamic choices,
yeah,
or, you know, the other kinds of things that you can change. It's still just really clear, beautiful singing.
Yeah. Every,
yeah,
bit of it.
Every bit of it. Every dang second.
Diriku hanya insan biasa, milikin naluri yang
Okay. Wow. I'm going to say something that I'm sure we've said before, but maybe we haven't. I don't know there's anything she can't do. Like, the last one we reacted to, she sang, like, kind of, like, rocky stuff, and we talked about how her technique and, choices apply to all genres.
Yeah.
And that was an example that just seemed kind of extreme from, like, the traditional Malaysian kind of pop she was singing. But this was, like, the most Western-style, like, runny, belty
thing kind of...
Yeah, that I've heard her sing. And she does it, like, as good as the best...
Oh, yeah.
Western poppy belters. Yeah. You know what
that
I mean?
Sounds like a professional singer to me.
She also has like a theater vibe.
Oh, yeah.
And a classical vibe.
Really
She's so dynamic.
And just really wonderful. I agree. Like, I think that this is why we say the same things over and over every single time again. Is because people think that you have to be this belty belter.
Right.
Or you only sing, you know, super light, this or that or the
it's
other
like
thing.
It's choice, like a choice, yeah.
You have, you know, if I took a guitar and I said I only play one style of music,
right,
that would be really limiting. You know, we play all different kinds of songs. Like, why wouldn't you want to broaden your horizons?
Right.
This is an instrument.
Yeah.
And you can use it correctly for any kind of genre.
Absolutely.
And Siti kind of shows us that she can sing healthy and consistently and with great resonance in
any style.
Any style.
And I would say for vocalists, for us, there's more at risk to singing in every style than there is for other instrumentalists. You're not compromising your technique a lot of the time to where it would be like something you can't change or recover from after doing it for long enough. Like, for example, if you sing with a pretty bad vocal technique to the point of where you like damage your voice, it's hard to come back. But if you play guitar in a rock style, you can always, you know,
put new strings on it.
Like, if you were to
rest a little bit,
exactly,
you'll be fine, you know?
Right. Like, and yes, you can create bad habits with other instruments.
Yeah,
but
people get hurt playing guitar too.
Absolutely. But I feel like the voice is so fragile in the sense that, like, we don't have the luxury of being able to just switch back and forth without really being intentional about our technique.
Mm-hmm.
It's just the reality of our instrument. So you can say, you know what, I'm always going to sing jazz, I'm always going to sing pop, I'm always going to sing this, and that's fine. But I think that you don't want to close those doors for yourself.
Yeah.
I mean, even just for your health, you don't want to close those doors for yourself.
And why not stretch? Why
Absolutely.
Not get better? Why not do, you know, practice more and do better? And, you know, if you're interested in being a professional singer, it's more important for you to be versatile.
Absolutely.
Be dynamic like Siti. Be
able to
sing all the things.
Absolutely.
And you'll get all the jobs.
All the jobs. And it does take a lot more work on the front end. We, you know, we would study in school, and a lot of times people would tell us, like, it's a combination of studying technique and growing up, like literally maturing your instrument. So so while your voice is changing, which happens through your 20s, you know, believe it or not, like it's not done after puberty. Your voice continues to change and will continue to change. And you know what I mean? Like, even with life events and things like that, losing weight, stuff like that, all those things will change your voice. But focusing on technique in the beginning of your journey sets you up for success as your voice changes, because you're really just teaching yourself to let your voice do what your voice wants to do.
Yep.
So it doesn't push you past those limits. And I don't mean like don't stretch yourself or don't challenge yourself or don't try to do better things. Don't push yourself past your limits to the point of no return.
Yeah.
To the point of not being able to do these things that you want to do vocally.
It's not worth it to us.
It's not
at
worth
least,
it.
You know, some people have commented
people
on the channel where they feel differently. They say, you know, I'd rather have 10 years in an amazing career versus, you know, 30 in a mediocre whatever.
Right.
You know, I literally wouldn't make that choice.
Right.
I personally can't imagine my life without singing.
Right.
I want to sing forever, and I can't, you know, why would I work so hard my entire life on something that would then be taken away from me?
Well, and I think people like Siti are proof that you don't have to compromise the incredible,
it's our whole point.
Impressive thing. Like,
yeah.
She is obviously not compromised those things. And look, she's doing really impressive stuff that impresses a lot of people who don't really understand, right? Like, the average listener would be impressed listening to Siti, just as they are listening to Morissette. But we're impressed because she's still doing it. And we know how she's consistently doing it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so I think that that's like, that's kind of our main point. You don't have to compromise. Like, you don't have to have a great career and a really talented voice or sing forever. You can have
both.
It's not either or. So, but that's just our soapbox.
We believe that. I don't know.
And this is our channel.
That's right.
Well, that was super wonderful to watch. We always love listening to CT. So thank you so much for sponsoring this video and for suggesting it. If you guys would like to sponsor a video, we will leave a link down below. If you liked this video, give it a like. And if you are new to our channel, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be notified next time we post. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.